Julia from the University of Auckland. In my last video blog, I introduced you to my PhD topic, invasive social wasps on New Zealand's offshore islands. This time, I'd like to take you on a trip to these unique islands, and together we're going to investigate the question, what drives wasp abundances on offshore islands? You ready? Okay, let's go. We've got 36 islands to survey. We measure wasp abundance using 5-minute wasp counts at 10 different sites on the island. Yeah, we just borrow this method from the bird people. Then we collide data on canopy cover, native and exotic vegetation, and human settlement, including farming. We note the size of the island and the distance to the mainland. We also gather data on invasive mammal presence or absence on islands, because anecdotal evidence suggests a link between mammal eradications and the disappearance of wasps on three islands, Te Hauturu Otoi, Tiritiri Matangi and Korapuki Island. Okay, let's see if we can prove this. Yes, there are no vespular wasps on the three islands. But hey, there are paper wasps on 92% of the islands. What we want to find out is what drives wasp abundances. So let's run a GLMM with the factors we collided and select the best model to find out which factors are correlated with wasp counts. Okay, so here are the results. These are the factors that significantly correlate with vespular counts. Island isolation, which is distance to the mainland, canopy cover in percent, and recent human settlement. That means that faraway islands that have high percentages of canopy cover and are uninhabited have less wasps, while close by, inhabited islands with little canopy cover have high vespular counts. Polistes abundance correlates with canopy cover only. The higher the levels of canopy cover, the lower the wasp counts. This is not surprising, as polistes as well as vespular wasps are adapted to open grass and pasture land. Surprising is that in contrast to our hypothesis, we found no correlation between mammal presence and wasp abundance. But there is one factor that is particularly interesting, as invasive species are often regarded as the villain of the virgin ecosystem. Our results show that human settlement is the major biotic driver of invasive vespular wasps on islands. I leave it to you to decide about the villain in this story, but I personally think that science doesn't need villains. Let's try and understand causes and consequences instead. It's time to leave the islands and fly back to the mainland. I hope you enjoyed the trip. Thanks to you and many others for supporting my research.